Hi, I'm Danielle Amstrup, and I'm the Executive Director of the St. Anne Hospital Foundation. Our foundation mission is to engage our communities so that everyone has access to exceptional health care close to home. This year and throughout the pandemic has proved that our mission is more important now than it ever has been. We invite you to listen to the stories from our frontline workers and our healthcare heroes and learn about all the ways that they have been going above and beyond for our community.
I will always remember when I first heard the news of our first COVID patient. If this patient does turn out to be positive, how many staff members would have been exposed? Fortunately, the hospital drills this type of thing all the time. We are very prepared in crisis management. But of course, this was just an unprecedented situation, and the world was in frenzy, and the ground felt like it was moving beneath our feet, and just really an interesting and stressful time for everybody that was involved.
The first COVID positive patient that I had experience with was back in March, and I found out he was positive on Sunday night when I received a call saying that I had been part of being exposed and that I needed to quarantine for a bit. That was difficult.
When our patient was admitted, we didn't know that you could have community-based spread, so therefore we weren't isolating patients. So we had a whole bunch of staff. A lot of our PCU, ICU nurses had, you know, pretty significant exposures, all tested negative, thank God.
It was almost surrealistic. Everything changed so quickly. COVID was so unknown. We didn't know so much about it. There was so much fear surrounding it. So in some ways, our work became bigger in that as we walked with patients and families, we were all also walking with the staff, with the respiratory therapists, with the nurses, with the doctors, because there was a lot of fear and just unease.
All the hospitals in the whole United States had a policy that we couldn't have the families and loved ones to come in. I had the opportunity to use the iPads to talk with the family members, and I saw how the patient would just touch the rims of the iPad all the way around, as if the family member was right there. And they were so elated to be able to have that connection.
We lost a 35-year-old, and he had three kids. So watching his wife walk out with his belongings bag.
Anybody that came in my way, I assessed the needs of how are you doing? And at times it was a pause in how they were really doing.
We had a patient who was going to be withdrawn to comfort care, meaning that we were going to remove her from the ventilator and let her pass peacefully. We all sat with her and helped her family say goodbye and held her hand.
The fifth floor of the Cedar Building, we converted all of the patient rooms to negative airflow as well, utilizing our, you know, our building controls. We're utilizing 100% outside air, exhausting 100% of that air, not utilizing any more air. So it's, you know, it's just like a safer mode of operation for the patients. And then in addition to that, one of the other things early on that the team did with the emergency physicians and the anesthesiologists was we developed what we kind of called a COVID shield to keep the staff safe when the physicians had to do the intubation process. Probably one of the most challenging things that I've done in my healthcare career, but I think that the hospital itself and all the teams worked together well to, you know, just kind of meet the challenge and do what we need to do to keep our staff and patients safe.
We tried to come up with a game plan for if the patient came back positive, which at that time, I think their test results were 2 to 3 days. So making sure we had all of the appropriate PPE. We were providing all of the necessary precautions to make sure that they were safe. All of the cleaning supplies that we had were the best available. They'd all been tested on emerging pathogens, so we knew that they would be effective. The St. Anne Hospital Foundation has provided tons of support during all this, from food for the staff to the two Trudy disinfection robots that we've actually been using on every single COVID discharge and every potential COVID room, just to ensure that the rooms are as safe as possible for our patients and staff.
And I know with the foundation, they didn't wait for us to ask for anything. They just jumped right in and helped us and provided food and treats and care packages, which meant a lot to the staff here, and it helped boost morale when a lot of us were fatigued, stressed, and scared. The foundation supplies the comfort carts for the families. So appreciated to meals, to food, to celebrations. The foundation does good work here at St. Anne. We really appreciate them.
If I were to describe it physically, I would feel like people literally had their hands on my back during that time.
The best part of this entire pandemic has been seeing the team really come together, all the leaders working together, doctors, nurses, everybody working extra long shifts just to make sure that everything got done.
It was pretty amazing the response that a little hospital like ours could manage.
I think what also makes us unique right now too is our COVID unit. You know, they've essentially become the best of the best in having to know how to respond and treat our COVID patients.
As you look at the mortality at St. Anne Hospital, our rates are far lower than overall King County and overall what the country is seeing. This community is a very diverse, underprivileged, underserved community. But when they come to St. Anne, they're getting the best care. And through so many heroic acts of nurses and doctors covering for each other, stepping up in ways that I just have never before seen, we were able to keep this hospital open and running and providing safe, compassionate care to all of our patients throughout that entire time.
The St. Anne Hospital Foundation is committed to continuing to support both patients and staff here at the hospital. We need your help now more than ever, and we are asking you to make a donation to our Emerging and Critical Needs Fund, which includes our COVID-19 response. We thank you for everything you've done to support our mission in the past and in the future, and we hope that you know if you ever need our help, we are here to take care of you.